guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I thought I'd talk about a more in-depth review of the Fabfitfun Spring 2019 box. So I received this box about two seasons ago. A lot of the people are asking me now if the box is really worth it. The value of the Fabfitfun box really depends on the person. You can have a box that's over $300 worth of products, but if you don't like any of the products in that box or you can't use those products in the box, then it's still not gonna be of great value to you, right? So I've had this box for about 6 months now, and I do have some thoughts and opinions about the box. So let's get started. So the first item that I got in my Fabfitfun box was this backpack, this canvas backpack. It has kind of like a color block style, you know, in the black and white, and it's by Dux Lux. I've never really heard of that brand before. I can tell it's like a really good quality brand. It has faux leather, and I've used this many times. So I really like this backpack because it's roomy. You can fit and throw anything in there. I like that it's white and black, and it just matches with any outfit that I wear. This is not just for the spring season, but you can definitely use this during the fall season as well. So I really like this bag, and if there's really one thing that I don't like about it is that I wish it had a zipper on it. Can't really take this to theme parks, which is the main reason why I would use this for more casual outings. You have to be very careful about, you know, what you put in there and how you carry the bag, because things could fall off. I've never really had anything fall out of the box, but you still have to be careful because there's no zipper. And the fact that it's a canvas bag, it gets dirtier a lot easier than other, let's say, leather backpacks where you could just wipe off the dirt. And so once you get something on it, it's just harder to clean up. So, but otherwise, I still love this backpack, and I've used this a lot ever since I got it in my Fabfitfun box. The next item that I got in my Fabfitfun box is the Quay sunglasses. I love these sunglasses. It's just perfect for my face. It's a little big, and it's probably not gonna be for everyone, so it just depends, but my face shape has been very versatile when it comes to sunglasses. Like, a lot of the sunglasses look really nice on me. Not to be bragging or anything. My very first aviator sunglasses, the only thing that I didn't like about it is the case, which would have been an added bonus to having the sunglasses, because it was the kind of case where you kind of open up like this and then it closes back. The kind of plastic material inside this was coming out. So I don't know if you can see, there's that rip right there. And it was poking me every single time, you know, I pressed it to open the case. It wasn't made really well. That's all I can say about it. So I wish that the carrying case was made a little bit better, but I have no complaints on the sunglasses. So still happy with this product that I got. One of the items in the box was a mystery item. I ended up getting the Deep Sleep Pillow Spray as a mystery item. And I was really excited about getting it because, you know, who doesn't need that extra sleep, right? So I love the smell of it. It's kind of like an earthy smell. My husband actually thinks the smell is overpowering. So it has essential oils of lavender, vetiver, and wild chamomile to help you wake refreshed. So I've used it a couple of times, especially when I've been really tired or I've had a lot of things in my mind. And honestly, I can't remember waking up and feeling really rested. It's not to say that it didn't do anything. If it did, it would have been very subtle. But it's still a full bottle, so I want to say it's not something that I kept using on a regular basis. So this is a meh product. I got this Ciate London Extraordinary Translucent Setting Powder. And I love this powder, and I would have never thought of getting it if it wasn't for Fabfitfun. If I didn't get it in my box, it would probably be one of the last powders that I would think to purchase, but I'm glad that we got this in our Fabfitfun box. One of my most favorite powders out there, and what I think sets this apart from all the other powders I've tried, is that it has brightening properties. So when I apply this under my eyes, it kind of brightens the area under my eyes and just perfects the makeup just a little bit more. So highly recommend this product, and I'm really satisfied that I got this in my Fabfitfun box. Okay, next one is the Champagne Charcoal Scrub, and it's an exfoliating body scrub. I'm about halfway through, and so I've used this many times. This product is just a meh for me. It smells good. It smells like champagne and oranges, like has a citrus scent, sugary sweet scent, but also very champagne-y. And I can definitely smell that while I'm in the shower. So it's supposed to really buff away the dead skin cells on your body and then give you a more moisturized skin. I feel like it's definitely buffing away those dead skin, but I don't feel more moisturized. I would say this is a very gentle charcoal scrub. It's not one of my favorites that I got in my spring Fabfitfun box, but I'll continue to use it. It's a nice way to pamper yourself, and I just love the aroma and the scent that it gives me while I'm in the shower. So I'll keep using it. Would I buy it again? Most likely not. Next one is the Ouai Leave-In Conditioner. I love this Ouai Leave-In Conditioner. I put this after I've washed my hair, and I actually even use it on my daughter's hair whenever I feel like she needs that extra hydration, because my daughter is in the swim team, and so her hair can get really damaged from the chlorine in the pool. And so when I feel like her hair needs a little bit of extra help, I definitely spray this on in addition to the conditioner that she uses at home. And it just makes her hair really soft. And the same goes with me. And it's so interesting because it looks like a solid, you know, kind of like a lotion-y texture inside the bottle, but when you spray it, it's really just a liquid. It's not gonna weigh your hair down or make it oily, but I feel like it's just giving you that extra hydration that your hair needs when it's extra dry. So love this product. I would highly recommend this, and I'm glad I got it in my Fabfitfun box. Next one is the Tula Probiotic Skincare Purifying Face Cleanser. I have a love and hate relationship for this cleanser. When it comes to the smell, when I first put this on, it smelled like manure on my face. I'm not kidding, I'm not joking. I grew up in the Philippines in a small town, and I know what manure tastes, tastes like. I know what manure, yeah. I know exactly what manure smells like. This exactly smells like that in some ways, and it's pretty strong. It doesn't linger while I'm scrubbing my face, while I'm cleansing my face. I'm sorry, Tula, please don't hate me, because actually I love this cleanser. And when I found out that it's actually being sold at Ulta, I got even more excited. As you can see, it's kind of running out, and me and my son have been sharing this cleanser, and I actually told him to slow down and not use it because I was trying to conserve it. That's how much I love this cleanser. I haven't read much about probiotics and that being present in skincare. Whenever I use this, I feel like my face is really clean, hydrated, and plump. Like, I feel like my cheeks are a lot more bouncy, a lot more hydrated. I love that effect that it gives me. Highly recommend this cleanser, and I would have never ever thought of buying this. I would definitely repurchase this cleanser again. There's something about the probiotic ingredient, and I really want to know more about that. Tula is a newer upcoming brand at Ulta, and so I can't wait to try all the other products that they offer. So the last item in my Fabfitfun box is the Needles No More Baggage Eye Depuffing Gel. I've used it many times. So the idea is that this is supposed to depuff. It did not depuff my eyes at all. It's supposed to hide dark circles, maybe just a little, and I think it's because of that, I don't know if you can tell, that orangey tint that it has. it actually dries down under the eyes a little too much. So it's not giving any kind of hydration under the eyes. And because of that, it makes the eyes feel and look really heavy with the concealer on. And so I've tried probably 5 different types of concealers with this eye cream. Makes my under eyes look like I'm 10 years older, heavy, weighted down, and it just doesn't look refreshed. It just looks dry. It creases concealers that I've always used. I do not recommend this eye gel at all from Dr. Brandt, and it sucks because I love Dr. Brandt's microdermabrasion exfoliator. A lot of Dr. Brandt's products are really good, but this one, I feel like it doesn't do anything, especially for the price. I believe this is like a $45 eye cream. I've tried it on my mom too, who has really deep set and just heavy bags under the eyes, and it didn't do anything. Yeah, don't even waste your time on this one. So out of the 8 items that I got in my spring FabFitFun box, I really, really liked all 5 of them. So I got my bag, my sunglasses, the Quay conditioner, the Tula cleanser, and also the translucent setting powder from Ciate London. Overall, did I get my money's worth? Definitely I did, because the bag alone, the Dux Lux bag alone, is like $40-something, which is pretty much the price of the box itself. And then plus all the other 4 items that I like, that I'm very, very happy with, I'm able to put to use 5 out of the 8, and I think that's great. Do I regret purchasing FabFitFun box? Not at all. Even though I didn't like these 3 items, I know I can still keep using them. It's not like, oh, they're trash. They're not the worst products. I just wasn't wowed by them. I still recommend subscribing to FabFitFun, because I got a variety of things: health, lifestyle, beauty items, fashion items like the sunglasses. You get a good variety of products that could suit anybody's preferences, style, and interests. So FabFitFun is definitely worth trying. If you are interested, I have a referral code down in the description box below, so check that out. And that actually saves you $10 or $15 off your first box, so I'll put it down here in the description box. So that's it, guys. Hope you liked this video and learned something. Comment down below if you'd like me to give you an update on my summer FabFitFun box. So I've had a good run with it, probably about 3 to 4 months now, so I've used some of the products already. I can't wait to talk about it if you are interested. So let me know if you like this kind of video where I follow up on the items that I got from FabFitFun. That's it, guys, for this video. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post videos once a week, and I'll see you back in my corner soon. Bye.